came with many questions here. The first question that I will pose you is, can we put sky into a bottle? Do you think it's possible? Can we close this unframed sky into a bottle? In 2002, I was at MIT making my postgraduate studies and research affiliation there. I had a crazy idea to make a cubic cloud. This had not realized, but I met an excellent nanomaterial. This NASA nanomaterial, it is 99% air and 1% glass. It looks blue in black background, and when light passes through, it is getting orange, like our sunset. So I started to investigate this material and to apply it in visual arts. Up to 2002, nobody had applied this material into visual arts. NASA and space agencies, they use this material to collect stardust. I use it as the personification of nothingness. It's 99% nothing. Imagine how beautiful sculptures you can make with 99% nothing. So I started to make my first sculptures named aerosculptures. 99% air, 1% glass. In fact, it's a solid. It is this material and the sculptures, you can touch them, but in the first sight, you don't believe that this is true. You think that it is like smoke, and you want to touch it. So you want to extend your sight to the tips of your fingers, like Thomas, St. Thomas. You want to touch the holy. It looks like a phantom. It looks like a phantom. It looks like a spirit. Imagine that it is 99% nothing. So it's like, it's not there. The other reason that I use this material for my work is that it is not only the personification of nothingness, but it is also the incarnation of our sky in danger. We are living is a protective layer that it is almost destroyed. If we continue this way, it will be destroyed. And here is coming another question. Can art give solutions? We will see it later. I want to speak about the sky, about the save our sky, not save our souls, SOS. Save our sky, because this sky is mine and it is inside the ether of my soul. The sky is yours. It's inside your heart. inside yourself. Do you want to see it destroyed tomorrow? Here is the broken nymph. And I put the broken beauty of our sky inside the bottle. Here is my answer about if we can put sky in a bottle. I started investigating this material, as I told you, in 2002. In 2004, because of thanks to a scientific experiment, it is that we made in India, we created there the first cumulus cloud. The scientists said, no, please, it's a failed experiment. I say, no, it's a nice experiment. And since then, 2004 until 2008, that I made the bottlet nymph, I had hesitation about if I have to put this in public. I was thinking probably it's a hubris to put sky in a bottle. Finally, yes, 2008, I put not only this bottlet sky, bottlet nymph, but many clouds into a bottle, and they are online. And here is Noli me tangere. Noli me tangere in Latin means touch me not. It's like our sky is talking to us. It's like our sky is talking to us and saying, touch me not, because if not, I will be destroyed. You will destroy me. This silica aerogel disc is again the same nanomaterial. And here I created a black and white cloud. And you see the laser pointer hitting a refracted laser light, laser beams, creating this dramatic red laser beams into this material that looks like frozen smoke. In fact, this my sculptures, they look like solid foam, like a glass foam. I have it here, the small bottle with the cloud. You will see it later on. In the Lonely Metangere, we have another question. If the sky is broken, as I told you, can art, me as an artist, can I have an answer about how to solve this problem of broken sky? And there I started the climatic sculptureality, here we have the Climatic Sculptureality Project. What is the Climatic Sculptureality Project? That first of all, I create new words, as you see, from sculpture and reality. We have sculptureality. I want to create moving clouds, not permanent clouds, inside my sculptures. But these moving clouds inside the aerosculptures can help other science to solve the problem. Art is questioning. Art poses questions. Art does not give answers. Science does. I'm not a scientist, I'm an artist. And if scientists, they like methodologies, we artists, we like mythologies. In fact, I'm not even an artist. I'm a bridge in between these two disciplines. Interdisciplinary research, interdisciplinary projects, they break silos between art and science. This is my role of bridging these elements, a space in between art and science. There was a mathematician, Henri Poincaré, who said that there is a space in between dimensions, B dimension, 3 dimensions, 4 dimensions. We have other dimensions that we cannot measure. We have to feel them. A mathematician is speaking about feelings. Why not then an artist to speak about science? So I started the Climatic Sculptureality, and I posed the questions. does my climatic sculptureality, could my climatic sculptureality help environmental scientists to think differently and improve their experiments by creating microclimatic conditions inside my sculptures and examine the climate change phenomenon inside sculptures? Could health science improve the drugs of the future by creating nanomaterials inspired by the nanocloud that I'm talking about? Imagine, probably the next generation will have a nanocloud of slow-release drugs inside your body that it will generate your health. It will generate and control your health. And the last question about architecture. This material is a super insulator. As it is 99% air, it can withstand 1200 degrees Celsius. So it's a super insulator. If we apply this material into the insulation of our buildings, then could we save these pollutants that they create the catastrophe of our sky? As I told you, there are many questions an artist can have. No answers from art. Do not expect answers. The answers are given from science. The future of climatic sculptureality is a fruitful one. And for now, I want to share with you something that you will not believe. These sculptures that you have seen before, the bottlet nymph and the noli me tangere, will travel one way to the moon. It looks like a storytelling, but it's true. These two artworks were selected as part of the Moon Art project to travel to the moon one way with a sculpture not bigger than your thermos of the water that you have today, and will stay forever on the moon. These photos, my bottlet nymph and my noli me tangere, are captured by Save Our Sky distress signals. I hope these same photos, they will inspire us to change our behaviors and live always under a beautiful sky. Thank you.